the real truth behind Bob Marley's death. Bob Marley brought reggae music into the mainstream with numerous critically acclaimed albums released during his short, roughly 20-year-long music career. His music transcended racial and cultural divides, and the man himself was an outspoken Rastafari icon, an activist in favor of legalizing marijuana during turbulent times back in the 70s. So, when Bob Marley passed away at just 36 years old, rumors began to circulate about foul play. Was Marley assassinated? Join us as we uncover the real truth behind Bob Marley's untimely death. Bob Marley's career blended traditional Jamaican music with elements of ska and rock to appeal to pop audiences who would otherwise never explore his style of music. Marley used his music platform to promote the ideals of Rastafarianism, which is a specific interpretation of the Christian Holy Bible that focuses on African diaspora, to speak out against oppression, and the religion also preaches the use of cannabis as spiritual practice. Marley married the Cuban-born singer Rita Anderson in 1966, and he had a fling with Cindy Breakspear, and altogether had 11 children. Together, Marley and his family would travel to perform concerts like any other musician, but Marley often played shows in support of his religious and political beliefs. Unfortunately, Marley's career wouldn't last much longer, though. He died in 1981 at the young age of 36. Rumors began to speculate that Marley's political activism had made him an enemy of the U.S. government. Some even believe he was murdered by the CIA. Their first supposed evidence comes from crazy shootout at Hope Road. In 1976, Marley was slated to play at Smile Jamaica, a free concert created by the returning Jamaican Prime Minister, Michael Manley. Manley was a divisive character, and political tensions were growing between his party and his oppositions. So he tried to set up a concert to bridge the gap. Just 2 days before the concert, Marley, his wife, and his manager Don Taylor were assaulted by an unknown gunman inside Marley's home. The attack was believed to be targeted at Marley because of his support for Manley, and during the attack, Marley was reportedly shot in the chest. Despite being seriously wounded, he still got up on stage and performed for the crowd of 80,000 fans and supporters. After Marley successfully recovered, conspiracy theorists believe the CIA attempted different methods to silence the Rastafarian musician. They allege that Carl Colby, the son of the former CIA director William Colby, gave Marley a pair of boots designed to sabotage the Jamaican activist. They claim that a radioactive copper wire was placed inside the boot that pricked his toe, causing his cancer. These theorists claim that Marley's skin color should have made him harder to contract a melanoma, since it's more common in fair-skinned individuals. But the Mayo Clinic has shown that melanomas can still occur commonly in dark-skinned people, particularly in hidden areas that don't get much sunlight, such as under a toenail. Others claim that Marley's German diet physician was a former SS officer working with the CIA to poison Marley. Adding fuel to the fire is the rumor that a CIA agent confessed on his deathbed to killing the reggae superstar. This particular theory was around for years, but it was reignited in 2019 when an Instagram page titled "Submit Conspiracy Theories" reposted the theory to viral acclaim. This theory claims that a former CIA agent by the name of Bill Oxley confessed to poisoning Marley in his last dying breath. But did that really happen? Here's what we know about Marley's passing. We know that despite his miraculous performance at Smile Jamaica, following his full recovery from his gunshot wound, Marley's troubles weren't over. The very next year, Marley was playing football when he injured his foot. It seemed worse than normal, and it gradually worsened to the point where he had to visit a doctor. At the doctor, he discovered that he had acral lentiginous melanoma, a form of skin cancer that developed from underneath the nails of one of his toes. Doctors advised that Marley get his toe amputated to prevent the spread of the cancer, but Marley's strong faith opposed the procedure. The Rastafarian faith puts a strong emphasis on the body as a temple of God, so removing any part of the body is considered a sin. Instead, he agreed to a skin graft, but it only delayed the inevitable. Marley continued his music career, releasing his most famous album, Exodus, that same year, and he dropped an album every year for the next 3 years with his group, The Wailers. During his 1980 tour, Marley collapsed in Central Park while jogging. With a true warrior spirit, Marley played another concert in Pittsburgh in September of that year, a show that would mark his final musical performance on stage. After Marley's Pittsburgh show, he canceled the remaining dates on his tour and flew to Germany for a unique therapy, a diet-based treatment administered by Joseph Issels. Marley stayed the night in Germany for 8 months, but the treatments were unsuccessful, so he flew back to Jamaica. On his flight home, his condition worsened, so upon landing, he was immediately rushed to a hospital in Miami. On May 11, 1981, at the Cedars of Lebanon Hotel, Bob Marley passed away. His son Ziggy Marley was there with him, and Marley's final words to his son were, "Money can't buy life." Later that month, Marley was given a state funeral back in Jamaica, with a eulogy delivered by Prime Minister Edward Seaga, who said, "His voice was an omnipresent cry in our electronic world. His sharp features, majestic looks, and prancing style a vivid etching on the landscape of our minds. Bob Marley was never seen. He was an experience which left an indelible imprint with each encounter. Such a man cannot be erased from the mind. He is a part of the collective consciousness of the nation." Marley was buried in a chapel near his birthplace along with his signature Gibson Les Paul guitar. It turns out that the claims of Marley getting poisoned or sabotaged with radioactive wires were all hoaxes that have been debunked. Marley died a devout believer in the sanctity of his body as a temple and never wavered from his conviction. Though his death was tragic, he remains a symbol of strength and integrity that can't be cheapened by conspiracy theories. Bob Marley's legacy remains inspirational and his music poignant and relevant to this very day. What are some of your favorite moments from reggae's greatest star? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed learning about the crazy theories surrounding the life and death of Bob Marley, let us know by clicking that like button and subscribe for more videos just like this one.